We're asked to complete the multiplication problem. We have 873 times 29. And notice how some of the digits have been provided for us. We need to enter the missing digits in the boxes. We begin by multiplying by 9, and the first product is 9 times 3. Well, 9 times 3 is equal to 27. So we place a 7 in the ones place value, and for the 21s, we perform an exchange for two 10s. So we place a 2 in the tens place value here, above the 7 that's already in the tens place value. And next we have 9 times 7, which equals 63, but then we add the 2, which gives us 65. So we place a 5 in the tens place value and a 6 in the hundreds place value. Now the reason for doing this is when we multiply 9 and 7, it's really 9 times 70 because the 7 is in the tens place value. Well, 9 times 70 is equal to 630 plus these two tens, which gives us 650. This is the reason why we have a 5 in the tens place value and we place the 6 in the hundreds place value. Next we have 9 times 8, which is equal to 72, plus the 6, which equals 78. Because this is the last product involving 9, we go ahead and write down 78, where the 7 is in the thousands place value and the 8 is in the hundreds place value. And again, the reason for this is when we multiply 9 and 8, it's really 9 times 800 because the 8 is in the hundreds place value. Well, 9 times 800 is 7,200 plus these 600s, which gives us 7,800. So again, we have the 8 in the hundreds and the 7 in the thousands. Now that we've multiplied by the 9, we multiply by the 2, but notice how the 2 is in the tens place value, so we're really multiplying by 20. And because of this, we place a 0 in the ones place value. Now when multiplying by 2, we first find the product of 2 and 3, which is 6. So we place a 6 in the tens place value. The reason this is in the tens place value, again, is because it's really 20 times 3, which equals 60, because the 2 is in the tens place value. And we can see the 60 here in the correct place values. Next, we have 2 times 7, which is 14. So we place a 4 in the hundreds place value and perform an exchange and place a 1 here, which really represents 1,000, because when we multiply the 2 and the 7, it's really 20 times 70, which is equal to 1,400. And now our last product is 2 times 8, which is 16, but then we add the 1, which gives us 17, which we can see is already here, where the 7 is in the thousands and the 1 is in the 10,000s. Now the reason for this again is because when we multiply the 2 and the 8, it's really 20 times 800, which is 16,000, plus this 1,000, which is really 17,000, which is why we have a 7 in the thousands and a 1 in the 10,000s. And now we add our partial products. 7 plus 0 is 7, which is already here. In the tens, we have 5 plus 6, which is 11. So because we have 11 tens or 110, we place a 1 in the tens and a 1 in the hundreds. And then for the hundreds, we have 8 plus 4, which is 12, plus 1, which is 13. Because 13 hundreds is 1,300, we place a 3 in the hundreds and a 1 in the thousands. In the thousands, we have 7 plus 7 plus 1, that's 15. Because we have 15,000, we place a 5 in the thousands, a 1 in the 10,000s, and 1 plus 1 is 2. So the product is 25,317, which we normally write with a comma between the thousands and the hundreds. I hope you found this helpful.